In this video, I will be showing you Enscape Impact. This is an energy analysis tool built right into Enscape. Now, what I love about it is the directness of it and the ease of use. Worst thing about the energy consumption analysis in the AC industry is the fact that it's so complicated. Just presenting energy data to clients is a nightmare. Endless schedules and graphs are pretty useless. Enscape Impact is clear and simple, not only for clients, but also for us as architects. It makes everything so much easier. What are the results? Do they match our goals? No? Okay, how can we make improvements? Oh, the red parts of the building. Perfect, let's fix it. So simple. Let me show you the step-by-step. Let's go. Just a quick introduction now. Enscape Impact, developed in partnership with global climate tech company IES, is a brand new add-on designed to seamlessly integrate real-time rendering with building performance metrics. It empowers you to optimize building performance and sustainability directly within your workflow to enhance your creative vision. When we know the fact that building accounts for almost 40% of global energy-related carbon emissions, designers are obligated to forecast buildings' energy consumption and assesses the key performance metrics of the building. Enscape Impact helps users with fast and easy energy modeling simulations. Enscape Impact allows users to perform early-stage design optimization and shortens the feedback loop, leading to buildings which are more energy efficient and cost-effective to build. Users can now adjust design and analyze a building's performance without leaving the design environment. Enscape Impact gives them the immediate feedback on peak loads, total operational carbon emissions, energy use intensity, and more. Unlike standalone analysis tools or softwares without integrated analytics, Enscape Impact lets users make data-driven decisions, quickly enriching both the aesthetic and functional quality of buildings while ensuring cost-effectiveness and energy efficiency. Now, if you would like to learn more about Enscape Impact or try it out for yourself, I'm going to be leaving a link up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. So now, let me show you the step-by-step. Let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. This is the model that I'm going to be using for this demonstration. It's our project 2 from the beginner course. I'm just going to select the topo solid as well as the road that we have here around, and I'm just going to hide it so it doesn't interfere with our analysis. So now let's start Enscape. So I'm just going to go to the Enscape tab and click on Start. Here in Enscape, let's navigate a little bit better around the building. Okay, so we have a nice view of it. So here I'm just going to go to the ribbon and find Enscape Impact. So you can just click here or use the N shortcut for that. Now, before we can get anything on our dashboard displaying all of the data, we need to first go into settings and we need to fill out the requested fields. So first things first, the location. So for location, I'm just going to put my hometown of Belgrade. So select that. Then we have the building type. So this is obviously an office building. So I'm just going to pick that. Building year. So let's say 2023. And last renovation, I'm just going to leave that blank because, well, it's a new building. Now you can see that the data is being processed. So it's pulling all of the data from our model and running all of the calculations from our model geometry and templates provided by IES software integration and running all calculations. Enscape Impact automatically detects and analyzes room data from your project's geometry to provide energy performance insights. To start the calculation, also location, building type, and year is required to determine the appropriate default data sets to assign. These data sets are developed by IES based on ASHRAE standards and user manuals. Datasets enrich the model with data for heating, cooling, DHW, lighting systems, etc. Calculations are performed by IES's Apache engine. Once the data processing has been completed, we can go to the dashboard and here we can see the peak loads for both heating and cooling. We can see the total carbon emission, we can see energy use intensity, and the energy end use. Now, what I like about this is, okay, we have the graphs, we have the info, but if we go to the settings and turn on visualization false color, here you can see on the model itself, and this is actually in 3D, so I can orbit around and view this in 3D. Now here we can obviously see that for peak loads, the trouble parts are this side of the building here. We can also see the energy or heating energy, so that then covers the bottom part of the building as well as this kind of vertical part. For cooling energy, this is the most problematic spot, probably because it's an open space office with lots of windows. And finally, for solar gains, yeah, it's kind of covering the same area. So here we have that graphical info in 3D, which is what I really like, and we know that we should now focus on this part of the building if we want to improve the data displayed here on our dashboard. Now, apart from having all of these, all of this info in terms of the energy and use, here we have a nice graph, but we can also highlight or hover over the parts of the graph, and then we can see the actual value as well as the percentage. So here we have the space heating, we have the cooling, the hot water, the lighting, and the equipment. So all of that data is displayed clearly. So whether you're doing this for yourself in order to make analysis and informed design decision, or if you're using this to present to your clients and see where you would like to change the design in order to get better results in terms of energy efficiency, I think it's a very powerful tool. Us architects are visual thinkers, and also for the general public or investors, they usually like to see things visually. So that covers the Enscape Impact tutorial. As you can see, it is very simple, very shallow learning curve. It provides reliable calculations performed by IES's Apache engine, just like software that normally engineers would use. Similar data accuracy is accessible in your architecture workflow in just a couple of minutes, and you already know how to use it. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.